Hello and welcome to my channel Chemical Engineering Knowledge. In this lecture we will discuss about the plant efficiencies. So the plant efficiency, there are three types of efficiency. One is the overall efficiency. Another is the Murphree efficiency, and third one is the point efficiency. The overall efficiency is denoted by eta naught. That is the overall efficiency of the whole column. That is the efficiency of the whole column. Suppose this is a distillation column. It consists of various plate. This is speed, this is the bottom, and this is the top. So the efficiency of this whole column is denoted by eta naught. What is the Murphree efficiency? It is a plate efficiency. It is the efficiency of a single plate. Suppose this plate, the efficiency of this plate, suppose this is a distillation column. This is a single plate, so the efficiency of this single plate will be denoted by Murphree efficiency, and Murphree efficiency is denoted by eta n. Now, what is the point efficiency? It is the efficiency at a single point on a single plate. So, when we consider this plate, suppose this plate is considered here. This is a single plate. So, at a single point on this plate. The efficiency will be called the point efficiency. So the efficiency at a single point on a single plate. So the efficiency on a point on a plate. Efficiency on a single point on a plate is called the point efficiency. So if there are 3 points on this plate, so the efficiency at this point will be called the point efficiency. Similarly, the efficiency at this point will be called the point efficiency. The efficiency at this point will be called the point efficiency. So, first of all, we consider the overall efficiency. So, the formula for overall efficiency is, it is denoted by eta naught. Eta naught is equal to the number of ideal stages, or the number of ideal tray, divided by the number of actual tray, or the number of actual plate. So, overall efficiency is the number of ideal plate divided by the number of total plate. So the total ideal plate divided by the total actual plate is called the overall efficiency. So the number of ideal plate when divided by the number of actual plate, we will get the overall efficiency of the column. Suppose if the overall efficiency of the column is 60% or 0.6, then the number of ideal plate in the column and the number of ideal plate in the column is, suppose it is 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Suppose the overall efficiency of a column is 60% or 0.6, the number of ideal plate in the column is 6. What will be the actual number of plate required for the distillation or separation? So actual number of plate will be obtained from this formula. Efficiency is equal to number of ideal plate divided by number of actual plate. Number of ideal plate is 6, so this is the 6. Efficiency is 60, this is the 60 efficiency. So we will obtain the actual number of plate, which is 10. 10 number of actual plate, so 10 number of plate will be required to obtain the required separation. So this was the overall efficiency. Now what is called the plate efficiency? So Murphree efficiency is also called the plate efficiency. Murphree efficiency is nothing but it is the plate efficiency. The second type of efficiency is called the plate efficiency, which is also called the Murphree efficiency. So the second type of efficiency is the Murphree efficiency. Now what is the Murphree efficiency? Before discussion of Murphree efficiency, let us consider a distillation column. This is a distillation column. Now this is the tube. The tube is entering to the distillation column. Suppose this is the tube which are entering to the distillation column. This is the top product, the distillate, and this is the bottom, and there are number of plates. So here are, suppose this is plate 1, plate 2, is flat 1, flat 2, flat 3. Then this 3 plate are in there. Suppose these 3 plate are in the rectifying section. This is another plate. Another plate. Another plate. Suppose the numbering of plate are counted from the top. This is 1, 2, 3 up to N. And below the cube point, the numbering is. So this is plate N. This is N plus 1. And this is N minus 1 plate. So, and this is N. Suppose this plate is N. This is N plus 1 plate. And this is N minus 1 plate. So, similarly, this plate is, suppose this plate is plate number M. This is N plus 1 plate. And this is M minus 1 plate. So, M minus 1 plate is the cube plate. So, this cube is coming to the M minus 1 plate, this plate. So, this is the cube plate also. Now, before discussing the Murphree efficiency, we consider this distillation column and this plate. Now, in the distillation column, the vapor is coming from bottom towards the top, and the liquid is going downward from top to bottom due to gravity. So, suppose let us consider this plate M. There are two streams entering to this, the two streams leaving this tray. If we consider this to be two stream, one is the vapor is leaving this plate, the other is the liquid leaving this plate. The liquid leaving this plate will have a molar flow rate ln, and the vapor leaving this plate ln will have molar flow rate vm. Similarly, the vapor will enter to this plate from plate N minus 1. So, the vapor which are entering to plate number N from plate number N plus 1 having molar flow rate Vn plus 1. Vn plus 1, and this is the vapor leaving plate number N will have flow rate Vn, this is Vn, because the vapor leaving the plate N. Now similarly, the liquid which are coming downward from plate N minus 1 toward the plate N will have molar flow rate ln minus 1, ln minus 1. Similarly, the vapor leaving plate M will have molar flow rate Vm. The liquid coming toward plate M will be written as ln minus 1. So, the liquid which leaving the plate N minus 1. Similarly, the vapor leaving plate N plus 1 will have Vn plus 1, and the liquid leaving plate M, the liquid leaving this plate M will have Ln flow rate. So now the mole fraction of more volatile component in this stream. Suppose the mole fraction of more volatile component in this stream will be denoted by Yn. So it will be denoted by Yn. And the mole fraction of more volatile component in the liquid which are leaving this plate N minus 1 will have Xn minus 1. Similarly, the mole fraction of more volatile component in the stream which leaving N plus 1 plate will be written as Yn plus N 1. So, the mole fraction of more volatile component in the vapor which are leaving plate N plus 1 will be written as Yn plus 1. Similarly, the mole fraction of more volatile component in the liquid which are leaving the plate N will be written as Xn. Similarly, the mole fraction of more volatile component in the vapor which I mean the plate number M will be written as Ym. And the mole fraction of more volatile component in the liquid which I mean the plate M minus 1 will be written as Xm minus 1. The mole fraction of more volatile component in the vapor which leaving the plate M plus 1. The mole fraction of more volatile component in this vapor, in this vapor will be written as Ym plus 1. And the mole fraction of more volatile component in the liquid which are leaving the plate number M, which is denoted by Lm, will be written as Xm. So these are the mole fraction and molar flow rate of flow on the basis of more volatile component. Now, what is the Murphree efficiency? So, the Murphree efficiency is denoted by eta n is equal to the mole fraction of more volatile component which leaving the plate n, this one. The mole fraction of more volatile component in the vapor which leaving the plate n, this Pn, and this Yn. So, the mole fraction of more volatile component which leaving the plate N minus the mole fraction of more volatile component which leaving. So the mole fraction of more volatile component in the vapor which leaving the plate N minus the mole fraction of more volatile component, the mole fraction of more volatile component in the vapor which are leaving the plate N plus 1. So the mole fraction of more volatile component in the vapor which are leaving the plate N minus the mole fraction of more volatile component in the vapor which are leaving the plate N plus 1 divided by the mole fraction of more volatile component, the mole fraction of more volatile component, the fraction of more volatile component will be the mole fraction of more volatile component in the vapor, in this vapor, the fraction of more volatile component in this vapor, fraction of more volatile component in this vapor, fraction of more volatile component in this vapor during equilibrium minus fraction of more volatile component in the vapor which are leaving the plate N plus 1. Okay. This is the mole fraction of more volatile component in the vapor leaving the plate N. This is the mole fraction of more volatile component in the vapor which are leaving plate N plus 1. This is the mole fraction of more volatile component which are leaving the plate N during the equilibrium process. E is part of the equilibrium. So this is the mole fraction of more volatile component. The mole fraction of more volatile component in the vapor. Mole fraction of more volatile component in the vapor which are leaving the plate N during the equilibrium. During the equilibrium process. Minus the mole fraction of more volatile component in the vapor leaving the plate N plus 1. So this is the Murphree efficiency is denoted by this. Sometime, remember that sometime in small plates, the Murphree efficiency can be equal to the plate efficiency. It can be equal to the point efficiency. Now what is the point efficiency? The point efficiency is the efficiency at a single point of a plate. So the point efficiency is the efficiency on a single point in a single plate. So it is called the point efficiency. Now but first of all you should know that this Murphree efficiency can be greater than 100. In some cases, in large diameter column, the concentration gradient appear in the on a single plate. So sometimes the concentration gradient appear on a single plate. Then the concentration of more volatile component in the liquid changes as the liquid flow horizontally on a plate. So in that case, the average composition of more volatile component in the vapor will be greater than the actual composition of more will have 20 vapor. So enlarge the column are those columns whose diameter are very large, and in that case the liquid will flow horizontally on a single plate. And as the liquid flow horizontally on a single plate, suppose on this plate the liquid is flow horizontally, then concentration gradient will appear on a single plate. And if we take the average of the mole fraction of more volatile component in the wafer in this case, then the average mole fraction of more volatile component in the wafer will be greater than this YN, which is the actual mole fraction of more volatile component in the wafer. So when the diameter of the column, when the diameter of the column is very large, the inner diameter of the column is very large, then the flow on a single plate and when the fluid flow on a single plate horizontally, then a concentration gradient will appear on a single plate. So this type concentration, this is the distance on a single plate and this is the concentration. So suppose this is a single plate, this one is a single plate, this one is a single plate, and the concentration gradient will appear. The concentration of more volatile component and the liquid in this place will be large, and the concentration of more volatile component at this place will be small. So a concentration gradient will appear on a single plate. So this is the concentration CA, concentration of more volatile component. So concentration gradient will appear on a single plate, and due to this concentration gradient, the average mole fraction of more volatile component, suppose the mole fraction of more volatile component above this position is at these. Similarly, the mole fraction of more volatile component above this portion is this, and the mole fraction of more volatile component above this liquid is this. So if you take the average, this plus this plus this divided by 3, then in that case the mole fraction of more volatile component in the vapor above the liquid will be greater than this YN. And when the average mole fraction of more volatile component above the liquid, and when the average mole fraction of more volatile component above the liquid become greater than YN, this YN, then in that case the Murphree efficiency will be greater than 100. But in small diameter column, the Murphree efficiency is less than 100. The Murphree efficiency in the small diameter column is always less than 100. So Murphree efficiency is, in some cases the Murphree efficiency is less than 100, in some cases the Murphree efficiency can be greater than 100. So in large diameter column it can be greater than 100, in small diameter column it can be less than 100. So this was all about the Murphree efficiency. Now the third efficiency is the point efficiency. Now what will be the point efficiency? The third efficiency is called the point efficiency. So suppose this is a distillation column. This is a distillation column, this is the feed, feed is inching, distillate, bottom, these are the plate, these are the plate. Now if we consider this single plate, suppose this plate N, N plus 1, N minus 1, this is plate N, N plus 1, N minus 1. Now if we consider this single plate, and if we consider a single point, we consider a single point on this plate, then the efficiency of this point on this single plate will be called the point efficiency. Similarly, the efficiency of this point on this single plate N will be called the point efficiency. Similarly, the efficiency of this point on this plate N will be called the point efficiency, and the efficiency of this point on this single plate will be called the point efficiency, and the efficiency of this point and this single point will be called the point efficiency. So the point efficiency is nothing but it is efficiency on a single, the efficiency at a single point in a single plate. So the point efficiency is the efficiency at a single point and a single plate. So this is called the point efficiency. Point efficiency is the efficiency of a single point on a single plate. So it is the efficiency of a single point on a single plate. Now the point efficiency can be denoted by theta point, and it is nothing, suppose this is point, we are interested to find the efficiency at this point, at this point. So the vapor is coming toward it, the vapor leaving it, the liquid is entering to it, the liquid also passing through it. So if we are considering the vapor, these are the vapor. So this vapor will be denoted by yn plus 1. In this vapor will be denoted by yn. But suppose this is point 1. Suppose if we consider this point 1, this red is point 1. Suppose this one is point 1. This one is, yellow one is 0.2. This is point number 3, and this is point number 4, this is point number 5, and suppose this is point number, suppose this is point number 6. So suppose we are considering the point number 1, we are considering point number 1, this point. So what will be the efficiency at this point and this plate end? So it will be denoted by efficiency of point, or efficiency of point 1, and plate number n will be equal to yn, which leaving the plate n at point number 1, minus the mole fraction of more volatile component which are leaving the plate n at point number 1, minus the mole fraction of more volatile component which are entering to the plate n from plate n plus 1 at point number 1. So the mole fraction of more volatile component which are leaving the plate n at point number 1, minus the mole fraction of more volatile component which are leaving the plate n plus 1 and entering, and so the mole fraction of more volatile component which are leaving the plate n at point number 1 will be denoted by yn 0.21, this one, minus the mole fraction of more volatile component which are leaving the plate n plus 1 and entering to the plate n at point number 1 will be denoted by yn plus 1 comma 1 divided by the mole fraction of more volatile component which are leaving the plate number 1 when they are in equilibrium with the liquid which is leaving the same plate, minus the mole fraction of more volatile component which is leaving the plate n plus 1 and entering to the plate 1 at point number 1. So this is the yn1, the mole fraction of more volatile component, mole fraction of more volatile component which are leaving the plate n at point number 1, this point, this yellow, this point. Similarly, minus the mole fraction of more volatile component which leaving the plate n plus 1 and entering the plate n at point number 1, at this point. These are the vapor which are leaving the plate n plus 1 and entering the plate n at this point number 1, at this point, this is point number 1. This is point number 1. Divided by the multiplication of more volatile components which are leaving the plate number 1 at equilibrium minus the multiplication of more volatile components which are leaving the plate n plus 1 and entering to the plate 1 at point number 1. So this E is for the equilibrium when the vapor is in equilibrium with the liquid which is leaving the same plate. So this E will come here. Similarly, the efficiency at point number 2 on the same plate, suppose the efficiency at this point, it will be equal to yn2 minus yn plus 1, entry to point 2, yn, during the plate 2, during the equilibrium process, minus yn plus 1, so this is the multiplication of more volatile component. This is the multiplication of more volatile component which are leaving the plate n at point number 2 minus the multiplication of more volatile component which are leaving the plate n plus 1, leaving this plate n plus 1 but entering the plate number n at point number 2. So at this position, this is point number 2 and this is, they are leaving this arrow in the upward direction. This is point 2. So the multiplication of more volatile components which are leaving this plate and entering to the plate n, this plate, point number 2. We multiply this by n plus 1 into 2. And this is multiplication of more volatile components which are leaving the plate n at point number 2. During the equilibrium. And this is the multiplication of more volatile components which leaving the plate n plus 1 and entering the plate n at point number 2. This point. So this is for point number 2, similarly it can be obtained for point number 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. So generally we obtain that when we combine the point efficiency, we will obtain the plate efficiency. So if there are n number of points on a plate, suppose point 1 plus point 2 up to point n, it will be equal to the plate efficiency. Single plate efficiency, and the single plate efficiency is nothing but it is the Murphree efficiency. So this was all about the plate efficiency, Murphree, and overall efficiency. Thank you very much for your